detective?
Not now, Mr. Ward. Whatever it is will have to wait.
I don't think so. I'm offering legal assistance to Mr. Corinthos.
How do you know he needs it?
Well, when I heard you were bringing someone in for questioning, I figured it might be Sonny.
Maybe you ought to reconsider, unless you want to lose your recall election. Representing Mr. Corinthos is what got you in trouble in the first place, isn't it?
Well, that's really none of your concern now, is it, Detective? I reserve the right to defend whomever I please.
It's okay. I appreciate your help, but I don't want to get you any more trouble. The fact is, I had nothing to do with Damien's death, so I ain't got nothing to hide.
You sure you don't want me to stick around?
Yeah. I'm sure. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Okay. Anytime. I'll be seeing you around.
All right.
Take it easy, Councilman.
Nothing, sir.
Thank you.
Have a seat, please.
Okay.
Ah. Ah, boy.
This is Detective Alex Garcia. The time is 4:52 p.m., April the 2nd, 1996. I am speaking with Michael Corinthos, Jr.
So, Mr. Corinthos,
you claim you had nothing to do with Damien Smith's death, is that right?
That's right. Yeah. I'm not saying I'm sorry he's dead, but I didn't have anything to do with it. If I had killed Damien, I wouldn't have burned down the ward house to cover my tracks, now would I?
So let me get this straight. You murder a guy, but you're squeamish about the location.
Call it whatever you want. The fact remains, Mary Mae Ward was one of the few people in this town I genuinely respected. And as a matter of fact, I even made a big contribution to the ward house. I have the canceled check to prove it.
Your civic-minded generosity overwhelms me. But you could have made that contribution as a cover.
I was out of town the night Damien was killed.
So you could have hired a hitman to do it for you.
Ooh, that hurts. Let me ask you something here, Detective. What's my motive?
Motive?
Yeah, motive.
I'll tell you a motive. He was about to be indicted by a grand jury. He could have implicated you in all sorts of little schemes. You had plenty to be worried about. You were afraid Damien might try to cut a deal and give you up. So you arranged to have him taken care of.
Right.
You had someone following him, waiting for the right opportunity, which Damien gave you a guy when he decided to torch Ward House. When you got back to town, it was all handled nice. And sure, you may have had a bad moment or two when you heard about what happened to Ward House, but your main problem was solved. Damien Smith couldn't talk.
You got a big imagination there, Detective. But that's all you have, and we both know it. So I don't need a lawyer to give me my rights. Either you are going to charge me with something, or I'm walking.
Go on. Walk. Don't walk too far.